terms like endofunctor and category theory scare you as much as they do me, don't worry, you're in good company. I'm Kyle Simpson, but you know me online as Getify, and I'm excited for you to join us in V3 of one of my most popular courses, Functional Light JavaScript. I've been on a years-long journey to understand these functional programming principles, and I've been documenting that journey both in this course and in a companion book of the same name. I'm really excited for you to dive in with us as we look at closures, avoiding side effects, list operations, recursion, and so many more critical functional programming principles. You won't be able to learn functional programming overnight. Nobody can. It's a months and years long journey. But hopefully this course will be a great roadmap for you as you begin to take those incremental steps, taking your existing working JavaScript programs and making them communicate even better with functional principles. I'm excited to learn these concepts with you, so enjoy the course. Here's an add comment, which is going to construct an object and put some values into it, and then it's going to append it to the DOM. It's an impure function, right? That is, line 11 is an impure function call because we create a side effect with it, which is that we modify the state of the DOM in the page. But there's some interesting and useful stuff happening here that is separate from the side effects. Matter of fact, not only is there the side effect of adding to the DOM, but you might not have spotted the side effect, line 3, generating a unique ID. That's also a side effect. So is it possible for me to extract out the impurity and make that be at the edge, make it be on the shell, and not be obvious? Sure it is. How about if we change this code to look like that? We now have an not procedure called add comment, but a function called new comment, whose only job is to make a new comment object. But you'll notice now that it receives the comment ID as an input. We take comment ID, the unique ID generation, and we pass it in as an argument. And then instead of mutating the DOM inside of new comment, we return back the DOM element. We return back the thing that is the DOM element, and elsewhere we do the appending to the DOM. Now, that doesn't get rid of the side effect. It just extracts it to leave pure function wherever possible. That's what a functional programmer means by making pure functions and then having side effects on the outer shell. So here I have a composed two utility. This one can only handle two at a time. It doesn't handle 3 or 20, it just handles 2, okay? So if I grouped minus 2 and triple together and then composed that composition with increment, we get the same thing as if I compose triple and increment and then compose that with minus 2. So let me show you that code. So I'm going to say compose 2 of minus and triple, minus 2 and triple, that's line 12. That composition is composed with increment. So we still have the same right to left ordering. We're still going to do increment, triple, minus 2. The ordering is still going to be increment, triple, and minus 2. That's what F is a composition of. Then I have P here, which does compose 2 with triple and increment, and then that is composed with minus. Still the same order, increment, triple, and minus 2. The F and the P functions look different, but they have the same result because composition is associative. That's actually super useful to us because it means that we can actually do currying and partial application on our compositions. You don't have to know all the functions that are going to participate in a composition all up front. You could curry the compose utility and provide two or three of them now, and then take that result and compose it with something else later, and take that result and compose it with something else later. And what are you doing? You're creating a more specialized function every time, because we're using currying to make a more specialized function. So the associativity property of composition sounds sort of nuanced, but it's actually really critical to making composition so useful.